A note on how not to live your life. Don Clark, an outstanding actor, comedy actor. I've only seen him in this series. Is Don Danbury. Such a loser as the orange guy in the White House. With his obsession for fake news, let's introduce some fake news here. We're talking comedy. And it seems he was born out of an orangutan. That's the Bill Maher joke. For which he was sued to the tune of $5 million by this phenomenon. In a way, to make a parallel metaphor, we have how not to live your life. And in this comedy, indeed, we have a man, this Don Danbury, who is doing all the wrong things. He's sexist, he has this inheritance, but he doesn't really work. When he does, he gets involved in all sorts of crazy situations. He's exploiting Eddie Singh, for instance. He has a weird relationship with a next door neighbor, a woman who's 65 but also eccentric, over the top. So that's indeed an example, a reverse role model of how not to live your life. But it is funny because we know that we're not supposed to do the things the hero, anti-hero, does. But if we stretch this a little, Donald Trump is also an example of how not to live your life. Paradoxically, this is a bad example, a negative example, even if he reached the very top. He's the leader of the free world and the object of adoration for so many stupid people, and some who are just villains. Putin, it seems, is happy to have him there, interfere, trying to take Hillary out. We don't know to what extent he contributed to her loss. She won the popular vote, but not the college vote. One stupid thing there, among many. But I must say, I'm a fan of America. I owe a lot of what I have, at least in material terms, and in some spiritual, to some spiritual extent, to America, because I work for an American company. I've been in tourism, working for American clients. So there you have it. And I respect most of them, at least those who voted for Hillary. But there's a darker side, like everywhere, and that's the side which voted for this guy, who's an example of how not to live your life, even if you're president, because that's the message. You can reach the top, you can have money, you can have the absolute power, almost, but anyway, the most power you can get on this world, and still be an asshole, still be a failed human being. Yesterday, every day, every other day, this guy is doing something outrageous. And then again, and then again. He retweeted some fake films proposed by an extreme right in Britain, which is the equivalent of the Ku Klux Klan in America. And to make the point, people from Britain, including the widow of that killed MP, said it's like the Prime Minister of Britain going to America or just taking Ku Klux Klan messages and retweeting them. How can you do that? And then they're fake and they promote hatred. And instead of realizing, okay, maybe I made a mistake, which he never makes, he says, well, no, the Prime Minister should fight the Islamic State and forget, never mind what I say. This is how not to live your life for real. And it's not comedy, it's a real horror show. To quote Alex in The Clockwork Orange. And to not done this here. returning to Don Vanbury, a sort of Donald Trump, really. Silly, sometimes full of himself, insecure, hiding in the closet to watch the woman he likes, womanizing, abusive, predator sometimes, only with a gentle side, and funny at times and endearing, as opposed to this lunatic who's never admitting he's wrong. Even when he admits he made a mistake, he doesn't. I'm referring to the infamous bus recording when he said, I grab women by the pussy, that they should do anything. I assault them, basically. After which he said, yes, I was wrong, I said that. And now he unsays it. I mean, he's like, it was a conspiracy. Maybe it wasn't me after all. After he said it wasn't. This is crazy. This is indeed a pathological case. This is a man who is a psychopath and a lunatic.